Hi, this is Electronics. In this video I will review the small Bluetooth receiver module. This small board can receive the audio played on phone via Bluetooth connection. I've just got it a few days ago, it is still in the package which I will open now. At first glance you can spot the micro USB power input connection and the 3.5mm audio jack output. I make a closer shot so you can see the details. Now you can see the pads on which you can solder the wires for power supply or battery and the stereo audio output. It has a very small size. With the help of my digital caliper I can measure it. The board size is 30x30mm and the height is 7.5mm. To power up the board you can use a micro USB or any source which has more than 3.2 volts and less than 5 volts, which means it works well also with lithium ion battery. The blue light indicates that the device is turned on. I connect it to my homemade boombox, which I will present you in my upcoming video. Now I will try to connect it with my phone. You have to search on the device list for the XYBT and after pairing it connects.
The Bluetooth device is connected successfully.
A voice notification lets you know that the connection was successful. The voice notification sounds very bad compared to the DVCT 14 Plus Bluetooth receiver board's notification sounds. When you listen to music loudly and the connection breaks, this loud woman voice notification can be very annoying. Next, with the help of my variable voltage supply, I try the lowest voltage it can support. You can watch a build video about the variable voltage supply here. Below 3.2 volts shuts down, after that won't start back again for a while. Now I will measure the current drain of this small device with the help of my multimeter. If you don't know how to measure current correctly, you can watch it here in this video.
The Bluetooth device is connected successfully.
As you see, the quiescent current is around 60 milliamps and when music is played it rises to 33 milliamps. Next, I connect the output to the oscilloscope. As I power up the device, 600 mV DC appears at the output. I recommend adding capacitors after the output when connecting to a power amplifier, so no DC would go to the amplifier. In my case, I have capacitor at the input of the power amplifier, so I don't have to change anything. Using the function generator application on my phone, I send a sine wave to the receiver. The sine wave is clean enough, there are some high frequency noises but those are very small, so no LC low pass filter is required for this device. Now I will try to find the lowest and highest sound frequency it can support. I went down until 40 Hz and still the sine wave has 1.5 volts peak to peak. The highest frequency is 20 kHz, over this frequency it starts to flicker. This device has a wide range of frequency response, so it can be used for almost every speaker type. The coverage distance is about 7 meters, which is enough for this small device. On the circuit board, the AC6905A IC is used. You can find a datasheet for it in the video description. The price ranges from $1.60 to $3, so it is very cheap. All in all, this small Bluetooth receiver circuit is very good and I do recommend it. Before I end up the video, I'll just show you the pros and cons of this circuit. Also, you can find a link for this product in the description. Thank you for watching. Leave a like if you want to see more videos like this and don't forget to subscribe.